Hey everybody, and welcome back to another Blender Python scripting tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at enumerators, or a drop down menu, whatever you want to call it. So let's go ahead and just jump right in. First of all, let's change this to the scripting workspace. Then I'm just going to close this, make some room. Then when you're happy with the layout, go ahead and open up the script that you want to work with. So I created a little template script. If you want to use this and follow along, there'll be a link in the description. Go ahead and check that out. But essentially, it's just a panel with a blank operator. So if we go over here to run script, then if I press N, open up the sidebar here. And then if we go all the way down to the bottom, we'll have this template tab here. So this panel just has a blank operator. And when we click it, it brings up this pop-up menu and nothing happens. Let me just go ahead and delete the things in the scene. So the idea is when we click this button, it brings up the operator. We want to have an option of a few different things. So let's go down to the operator, and then in here we can create the enumerator. So let's give this a name. I'm going to call this preset underscore enum, then add a colon, and then I'm going to type bpy.props.enum property, then open and close parentheses. And then I'm just going to go in here and then press enter a few times. And it keeps everything neat and tidy. So let's go back here, and then I'm going to hit enter and then press tab just to indent it. And then we can type the name. And then we can separate that with a comma, hit enter, and then we can give this a description. Again, you can type whatever description you want. And again, make sure we separate this with a comma. Hit enter, and then here we can define the items, and the items would be a list of options that you can give the user to select from. So items equals, and because this is a list, we need to use the open and close square brackets. And then in here we can just define the options. So here we can just hit enter a few times just to give a bit of space, then go back to the top here, then I'm going to hit space, open and close parentheses, and this is going to be our first option. So let's give this an identifier name, so we can use the apostrophe twice. So you can identify it however you want. I'm going to type OP for option number one. And then after the apostrophe, I'm going to hit the comma, then quotation twice. Then in here, this is going to be the name of the option. So we're going to be adding a cube for the first option, and then add a comma. And then finally, we can add a tooltip description. So quotation, quotation. In between here, we can type something like add a cube to the scene, or something that's more appropriate to your option. And again, we can move this down. I'm going to hit enter here, then maybe indent it just so it looks nicer. So that's our first option. So at the end here, I'm going to add a comma, which will separate the next one. And then in fact, we can actually copy all this. After the comma, I'm going to hit enter, then I'm going to paste this in, and then we can just change this to option two. This is going to be a sphere, and we can change this. We could leave this blank if we want to. Again, make sure we add a comma, hit enter, control V, paste, and then just change this real quick. So there we go, that's the enumerator done. I'm just going to tidy this up a little bit. It's not necessary, but it just looks better. And if we run script, well, nothing will happen since we've not actually changed anything down here. We've just created the property. We've not actually displayed it or told it to do anything. So that's what we're going to be doing down here. We can go down to draw. I'm just going to hit enter. And then here, I'm just going to type layout.prop, open and close parentheses. And then within here, I'm going to type self, comma, quotation, quotation. And then within here, I just need to type the name of the enumerator, so we can just copy this, go back down, paste this in. So now when we run script, click this button, we can see it now draws the enumerator. And if we click this, we can see we have the different options. And again, if we hover over some of these, it gives us the tooltip. If we hover over this one, it doesn't, since we didn't actually add a tooltip. So then if we select one of these and click OK, nothing happens since we've not actually defined anything in the execute. So that's what we're going to do next. If we go down here, hit enter, And we're going to be using an if statement. So for example, if preset enum is equal to option 1, we want to add a cube. If preset enum is equal to option 2, then it's going to add a sphere. I'm going to type if self.preset underscore enum, then equal sign twice, which means is equal to, then apostrophe twice, add a colon, then in between here we're going to type the identifier name, which if we remember, option 1, op1. So if preset enum is equal to option 1, we want something to happen, so hit enter. We just want to add a cube. So that would be bpy.ops.mesh.primitive underscore cube underscore add, open and close parentheses, and there we go. And if you don't know how to do that, just shift A, go to whichever thing you want to add in. It should give you the tooltip if you have that enabled. If not, just add it in the scene. And then we can see down here, you can just copy and paste this in. So now if we run script and check, make sure this works. So now we have cube selected. If we hit OK, it should add a cube, which it does. And then if we change this to sphere, it shouldn't actually do anything since we've not defined anything. So that's pretty good. So we can see it doesn't add the cube a second time, which is good. So all we need to do now is just copy and paste this a few times. Copy this. Then if we go to the end here, hit enter. Then make sure you don't paste it in here because it won't work. You need to make sure that you move to the left. We just need to press the left arrow and move to the left. Paste this in just so it's in line with the other if statement. And then all we need to do is change this to option 2. And if we remember option 2, we want to add a sphere. So it's no longer cube. Let's get rid of this. And change this to UV underscore sphere. And then let's do this one more time. Option 3. So run script to make sure this works. Cube. Sphere. And Suzanne. Cool, so that works pretty good. So it's pretty simple, and again, these options can be more complex. Add some icons and things. I mean, in fact, if we go to the text tool add-on, go to this one. So this is pretty much the same thing. We have a solid line. Or if we want to change this to something else, dots or arrows or circles, we could do the same thing. So it's a little bit more complex in the execution on this side of things, but it's essentially the same process. You know, we have the draw method to display it. We have what's going to be executed. And then you have your enumerators here. Again, you can copy this and create another enumerator. So copy this, paste it in, make sure we change this to something else. And then all we need to do is just add this name down here in the draw method. So I'm going to copy this, paste it, and just change this name to another. Just change this name, run script, and then if we go back, we can see we'll have two, we can see we have two drop down menus. So I hope this video helped. If it did, be sure to hit that like button. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.